If you were wondering whether a cipher that can keep encrypted messages perfectly secret exists, it does. In this lesson, you will learn the requirements for a perfectly secret encryption system, the one-time pad, its cryptanalysis, and implications. The model of perfect secrecy based on information theory was developed by Claude Shannon in the 1940s. In this theory, the adversary is assumed to have access to unlimited computational resources to break through the encryption. For an adversary with unlimited resources, an unbreakable encryption scheme is one where the ciphertext conveys no information about the plaintext or the key. In other words, given any ciphertext, all possible plaintexts of that length are equally likely to have been the initial message. This is achievable if and only if the key is absolutely secret, the key is random, the key is at least as long as the plaintext, and the key is never reused. Now you will see how such a system could work, how one could attempt to break it, and how the preceding conditions will prevent it from being broken. One-time pad is an example of such a system. The name pad originates from the early uses of this encryption system by secret organizations. The keys for several future communications were printed on paper notebooks, pads, and had to be kept completely secret, and every used page had to be destroyed. Consider encrypting this IRL shot. The key is required to be at least as long as the plaintext. So in the case of this picture, the required key size is equal to the photograph's byte dimensions. The key has to be randomly generated as well. The meaning of random encryptography and random number generators are discussed in detail later in this course. The encryption operation would be simply adding each byte of the image with the corresponding byte of the key. Since here you are working with bytes, the addition is binary and equivalent to exclusive OR operation. And the encrypted image looks like noise to anyone who's intercepted. The intended receiver, who should already have the key, would add the key values back to the noise and get the photograph in all detail. One-time pads were used in communications between top commanders by both sides in World War II and later for strategic communications between NATO allies and for the hotline between US and USSR heads of states. Now imagine you intercepted a text message from a spy encrypted with a one-time pad. Simplify the analysis by using letter positions in the alphabet as encoding instead of byte values. A possible key can equally likely be any of the random combinations of six-letter codes. Since you are using letter positions of the alphabet, encryption and decryption here are addition and subtractions model 26. Instead of exclusive OR as in the previous example. Try decrypting the ciphertext with this random key. You're getting a random combination of letters. Trying all possible six-letter keys is not much work for a computer. There are only limited a number of possibilities. However, since the key is completely random, trying decryption with all the possible keys will give you all the possible plaintexts. That are equally likely. Assume in this case that you know that the plaintext was a meaningful English word. Here are some keys that are gonna give you back valid words. Even if you knew or guessed somehow that the spy's original message was a city name, there are still too many choices. Any six-letter city, like Boston, Berlin, or Madrid, will come up as a possible plaintext. Thus, regardless of how many decryption attempts you do, you cannot know which of the decrypted messages is the original plaintext. In Shannon's definition of perfect secrecy, the adversary is modeled to have unlimited resources at their disposition to break the encryption system. With this assumption and the aforementioned requirements on the key, a system such as one-time pad is proven to be impossible to break. So if you can use a unique key for each message, simple arithmetic can give you ideal security. These same requirements, however, render such perfectly secure systems impractical for most applications, de facto reserving their usage to critical top-secret state and military communication. Modern cryptography assumes instead that the adversary's computational resources are limited by technology of their time and foreseeable future. In this more relaxed and realistic setting, the encryption system's security is understood as practical unbreakability, the infeasibility of breaking the encryption system with respect to the adversary's resources.